section. Bruins hosting rival Eastern, and their play on the field even louder. Ballard up big in the third when David Daniels takes the handoff, and he runs it in from the five. He's also pretty good catching the ball. They line up to kick the PAT, except not really.
Oh, wow.
Roland Green runs back, gets the ball, throws it to a wide open Daniels in the end zone. Eastern had no trouble moving the ball, though. They've got it on the four. The drive stalled out. Fourth and goal. Ryan Baker breaks up the pass, and Ballard goes on to win this one big. 53-13.
Kentucky football in Middletown. Third-ranked Christian Academy hosted Fort Knox. First quarter scoreless. Nick Payne delivers some. Got loose for 18 yards for the Centurions. And that set up this. Nathan Christmas to Chad Llewellyn. 13 yards for a touchdown to put Cal out on the board. And the lead 7-0. Still first quarter. Cal now by 14. When Payne delivers some again. And this time it's not the Eagles who suffer. Watch and listen.
That's my favorite part of the show.
Ooh! Our photographer, Sean Blevin. Ooh! An 11-yard touchdown run. 21-0 Centurions. Christian Academy improves its record this season to 8-0. Maybe the best in the young program's history. 49-14 win over Fort Knox. Now things got really tough finishing with the sales and mail.
Charlestown taking on Providence. We head over the river. Third quarter, Charlestown down 35-0. Antonio Gotti with a 50-yard run, and that is going to lead to a 1-yard TD run. They were down 35-6 after this score. Now, ensuing kickoff, though, Dorian Noel. Guess what, folks? After the hurdle, he's going to go right coast to left coast, completely untouched. 93 yards for the score. That makes it 42-6. Providence, they would go on to win 49-12.
And staying in Indiana, Floyd Central hosting Jennings County. Third quarter, and Floyd Central was up big, 32 points and counting. Jennings County trying to keep it close. Dakota Bott on the run here for 22 yards. That sets up a 2-yard touchdown run by Bott again to cut the Jennings County hole 42-17. But the rest, all Floyd Central. Gary Posey, a short TD run here, and Floyd Central wins it 54-30.
Plays of the nighttime, we head over to Central Hardin for a little trickeration. The wide receiver pass, Justin Rouse, is going to find Tyler Long. That is good for a touchdown.
And back out to Providence, and watch Dorian Noel. This kickoff return, he's going the distance, 93 yards back the other way for the score. Providence wins the game big as well, 49-12.
And over to Cal, we saw this just a few moments ago. Nick Payne on the carry, he gets it to the end zone, but what happens after that? The play of the night, Sean Blevins, our guy. Ouch!
The play of the night, man.
He's in the dark, but our camera's okay. He may not be, but our camera is okay.
Time for the best answer to our Twitter question of the night. We wanted to know, are you a fan? Are you for or against post-game handshakes, and why? And here is the response from TJ Rahill. Handshaking should be kept. It keeps the game classy. Win humbly or lose with your head up. Gotta learn to be a man.
I like that. Hey, I think we're out of time. We got to get out of here. Thanks for joining us on High School Playbook. Letterman's next. Have a great weekend, everybody. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.